Thank you. have mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
On each remembrance through all the holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, the Blessed Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Thank you. come, let us attend.
When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. suddenly a sound came from heaven like the rush of a mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared to them tongues of fire, distributed and resting on each of one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Now there were dwelling in Jerusalem Jews, devout men from every nation under heaven. And at this sound, the multitude came together, and they were bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in his own language. And they were amazed and wondered, saying, "Are not all of these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in his own native language? Parthians and Medes and Elamites and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabians, we hear them telling in our own tongues the mighty works of God. Peace be to thee that readeth, and to thy spirit."
Said about the Spirit, which those who believed in him were to receive, for as yet the Spirit had not been given, because Jesus was not yet glorified. When they heard these words, many of the people said, "This is really the prophet." Others said, "This is the Christ." But some said, "Is the Christ to come from Galilee? Has not the scripture said that the Christ is descended from David and comes from Bethlehem, village where David was?" So there was a division among the people over him. Some of them wanted to arrest him, but no one laid hands on him. The officers then went back to the chief priests and Pharisees, who said to them, "Why did you not bring him?" The officers answered, "No man ever spoke like this man." The Pharisees answered them, "Are you led astray also? Have any of the authorities or of the Pharisees believed in him? But this crowd, who do not know the law, are accursed." Nicodemus, who had gone to him before and was one of them, said to them, "Does our law judge a man without giving him first a hearing and learning what he does?" They replied, "Are you from Galilee too? Search, and you will see that no prophet is to rise from Galilee." Again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, "I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life."
Glory to thee.
And always, by the might of his God, glory unto thee. remember all of us in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Good and proud.
profitable for our souls, and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, pour a Christian end to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord.
And so, Lord,
calling to remembrance our all-holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Most Ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Trinity, one in essence and love.
hand right to give thee, to bless thee, to praise thee, to give thanks unto thee, and to worship thee in every place of thy vision. For thou art God, ineffable, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, ever existing and eternally same, thou and thy only begotten Son, of thy Holy Spirit. Thou it was who is bringing us from non-existence into being, and when we have fallen away, this graces of the heaven, and is not ceased to do all things until thou hast brought us back to heaven, and hast endowed us with thy kingdom, which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee and to thy only begotten Son, thy Holy Spirit. For all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. We give thanks unto thee also for this ministry, which thou hast vouchsafed to receive in our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of our angels, and then thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring aloft, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and singing.
Thank you. mankind, receiving them upon his holy heavenly and ideal altar, for an odor of spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us and return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for the unity of faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you, Christ our God.
Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom, not unto judgment, nor unto his soul and body.
Thank you.
God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Thank you.
now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
appearing from heaven upon his holy disciples and apostles in the form of fiery tongues for our salvation. Christ our true God, through the intercessions of his all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all laudable apostles, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves mankind. The prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
You may have noticed we didn't have a homily this morning. That's because we have a special surprise. We have another service. Because today is the Feast of Holy Pentecost, and the descent of the Holy Spirit, what some folks refer to as the birthday of the church. But you know, we have not knelt from Pascha until, well, 50 days later today, we made up for it. We abbreviated Vespers with prayers of kneeling. And we'll be right now.
Lord, have mercy,
that he may strengthen us
so that we may bring to perfection those things that well please him, let us pray to the Lord. And he may send down upon us his rich mercies, let us pray to the Lord. And he may accept the bending of our knees as incense before him, let us pray to the Lord. For those that are in need of his help, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. All we need to remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Grant us unto men their petitions before they ask, We pray thee and beseech thee, O Master, who lovest mankind, the Father of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and of the Virgin Mary, most glorious Theotokos, who did first teach in words and afterwards did show by deeds when he endured his saving passion, who didst give us thy humble and sinful and unworthy servants an example, whereby we should offer unto thee prayers with the bending of the neck and the knees, both for our own sins and for the ignorance of the people. Do thou thyself, who art great in mercy and lovest mankind, hearken to us in that day when we shall call upon thee, and especially on this day of Pentecost, on which, after our Lord Jesus Christ had ascended into the heavens and sat down at the right hand of thee, the God and Father, he did send upon his holy disciples and apostles the Holy Spirit, which he did also sit upon each of them, and they were filled with his inexhaustible grace, and they spake with other tongues of thy greatness, and they prophesied. Hearken therefore to us now, pray to thee, and remember us, humble and condemned as we are, and turn again the captivity of our souls, thou that hast thine own compassion and as an intercessor for us. Receive us who fall down before thee and cry, we have sinned, we have cleaved unto thee from our birth, even from our mother's womb. Thou art our God, but since our days have passed in vanity, we have been stripped of thy help, we have been deprived of every defense. But emboldened by thy compassions, we call out, remember not the sins of our youth and our ignorance, and cleanse thou us of our secret sins. Cast us not away in time of old age, when our strength faileth, forsake us not. Before we return to the earth, make us worthy to turn again unto thee, and attend to us in favor and grace. Measure our transgressions according to thy compassion. Set the depth of thy compassions against the multitude of our offenses. Look down from thy holy heights, O Lord, upon thy people here present, who await thy rich mercy. Visit us in thy goodness. Deliver us from the power of the devil. Make firm our lives with thy holy and sacred laws. Entrust thy people to a faithful guardian angel. Gather us all into thy kingdom. Grant pardon to those that hope in thee. Forgive them and us our sins. Purify us by the operation of thy Holy Spirit. Destroy the snare set for us by the enemy. Blessed art thou, O Lord, Master Almighty, who has enlightened the day with the light of the sun, and has illumined the night with flashes of fire, who has vouchsafed us to pass through the length of the day and to draw near to the beginning of the night. Hearken to our prayer and to that of all thy people, and having pardoned us all our voluntary and involuntary sins, receive our evening supplications, and send down the multitude of thy mercy and compassions upon thine inheritance. Wall us in with thy holy angels. Arm us with the armor of thy righteousness. Make a bulwark about us of thy truth. Guard us with thy power. Deliver us from every oppression and every plot of the adversary. Grant us also that the present evening with the coming night and all the days of our life may be perfect, holy, peaceful, sinless, without stumbling blocks, without fantasy, through the intercessions of the holy Theotokos and of all the saints, when all the ages have been well pleasing unto thee.
All mercy, have mercy upon us. Praise us up in peace, O God.
Bending knees
still in this life, but that the grant and gift of the all Holy Spirit be taken as an inheritance that cannot be taken away. Thou didst set down today in a man of Holy Spirit this grace upon the holy disciples and apostles, and just open their lips with love and fire. Through them every grace of man has received through the hearing of the ear, the knowledge of God in our own languages. We have been enlightened by the light of the Spirit, and we have been free from the delusion as from darkness, and through the distribution of the perceptible tongues of fire and the wondrous operation of the same, we have been taught the faith that is in thee, and we have known so as to praise thee with the Father and the Holy Spirit, in one Godhead and power and authority, who thou art the brightness of the Father, the express image, inalterable and immovable of his essence and nature, the fountain of wisdom and of grace. Open thou also the lips of me, the sinner, and teach me how I ought, and for one that is perfect. For thou knowest the multitude of my sins, but thy compassion shall overcome the enormity thereof. With woe and fire I stand before thee. Into the sea of thy mercy have I cast the desperation of my soul, and govern my life, though that governs all creation, with thy word and with the unutterable power of thy wisdom. O tranquil haven of the storm tossed, and make known to me the way wherein I should walk. Grant to my reason the spirit of thy wisdom, and give the spirit of understanding to my foolishness. Overshadow my deeds with the spirit of my fear, and renew a right spirit within me. And with thy governing spirit, establish my faltering mind, that being guided every day by thy good spirit toward what is useful, I may be vouchsafed to keep thy commandments and always to remember thy glorious coming again, which shall search out our deeds. Despise me not, lest I be deceived by the corrupting pleasures of the world, but enable me to yearn for the enjoyment of the treasures of that to come. For thou hast said, O Master, that whatsoever may be asked in thy name shall be freely received through thy compassion to thy people. Hearken to us from the holy, thy holy heaven. Sanctify them by the power of thy saving right hand. Shelter them with the shelter of thy wings. Despise not the works of thy hands. Against thee only do we sin, but thee alone do we also endure. We know not how to worship a strange God, nor how to stretch forth our hands to any other God. O Master, forgive us our offenses and accept our prayers. With the bending of our knees, extend to us all the hand of thy aid, and receive the prayer of all as an acceptable incense, rising above and before thy holy kingdom. O Lord, Lord, who delivers us from every error that applies by day, deliver us also from everything that walks in darkness. Receive the lifting up of our hands as an evening sacrifice. God, save us also to pass without reproach the course of the night, untempted of evil things, and redeem us from every disturbance and dread that comes to us from the devil. Grant us.
add to our soul's contrition, add to our thoughts care, concerning the trial of our fearful and righteous judgment. Nail our flesh to the fear of thee, and mortify our earthly members, that we sit in the quiet and so sweet, we may be illumined by the contemplation of thy judgments. Draw for us every unseemly fantasy and injurious desire, and gaze us under the time of prayer, burn the faith and progress in the
help us, save us, have mercy on us. Gaze us up and keep us, O God, in thy thy grace. All each remembrance are all before the Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Mystery. Ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Raises up, binding in infirmity and releasing unto power.
dispensing present things according to the need and ordering those to come as is expedient, quickening with the hope of resurrection those that are smitten with the sting of death. Thyself, O Master of all, Lord God, our Savior, the hope of all the ends of the earth and of those who are far off upon the sea, who on this last and great saving day of Pentecost did show forth to us the mystery of the Holy Trinity, consubstantial and co-eternal, undivided and unmingled, and is poured out the descent and presence of thy holy and life-giving Spirit in the form of tongues of fire upon thy holy apostles, appointing them to be the evangelists of our pious faith, and showing them to be confessors and preachers of the true theology, who also, and on this all-perfect and saving feast, does deign to receive oblations and supplications for those bound in Hades, and grant us unto us the great hope that respite and comfort will be sent down from thee to the departed, from the grief that doth bind them. Hearken to us, thy humble and admonious ones who pray, and give rest to the souls of thy servants who have fallen asleep before us, in a place of brightness, a place of verdure, a place of repose, whence all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. And do thou place their souls in the tabernacles of the righteous, and make them worthy of peace and repose. For the dead praise thee not, O Lord, neither do those in Hades dare to offer thee confession. But we, the living, bless thee, and supplicate thee, and offer propitiatory prayers and sacrifices for their souls. O God, who art great and eternal, holy and lovest mankind, who hast vouchsafed us also to stand at this hour before thy unapproachable glory, that we may give and praise thy wonders, be gracious to us, thy unworthy servants, and grant us grace, that with contrite heart and without presumption, we may offer to thee the thrice holy glorification and thanksgiving for thy great gifts which thou hast granted and dost ever grant us. Remember, O Lord, our infirmity, and destroy us not for our transgressions, but be multitude, be merciful to our humility, that fleeing from the darkness of sin we may walk in the day of righteousness, and clothed with the armor of light we may preserve unassailed from every attack of the evil one, so that with boldness we may glorify thee in all things, the only true God and lover of mankind. For thine is, in truth, the great mystery, O Master and Maker of all, both the temporary dissolution of thy creatures and their restoration thereafter, and of eternal rest. We confess thy grace in all things, in our coming into this world, in our going out forth therefrom, which things faithfully pledge unto thee, through thine unfailing promise, our hopes of the resurrection and of the life incorruptible, which we shall receive hereafter at thy second coming. For thou art both the author of our resurrection and the impartial judge of those that have lived, and the lover of mankind, and the master and lord of recompense, who didst partake with us on equal terms of flesh and blood through thine extreme condescension, and of our irreproachable passions, whereby thou dost willingly submit to temptation, since thou dost possess tenderness and compassion. And thyself, having suffered temptation, art become for us who are tempted the helper which thou thyself hast promised to be, and therefore thou hast led us to thy passionlessness. Receive therefore, O Master, our prayers and supplications, and give rest to all the fathers and mothers and children and brothers and sisters of each of us, and to every other of our kindred and of our people, and to every soul that has gone forth to rest before in the hope of resurrection to life everlasting. Set their spirits and their names in the book of life, in the bosom of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, in the land of the living, in the kingdom of heaven, in a paradise of bliss, leading all by thy radiant angels into thy holy abode, raising up also with thee our bodies in the day which hath been appointed according to thy holy and unfailing promise. There is therefore, O Lord, no death unto thy servants, when we go forth from the body and come unto thee, our God, what a change from things most sorrowful unto things most beneficent and most fruitful, and rest and joy. And though we have sinned against thee, be gracious unto us and unto them who
born not as pure, stained in thy sight, though his life be but for one day. Except thou alone, who didst reveal thyself sinless on the earth. O Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we all hope to obtain mercies and the forgiveness of sins, do thou therefore, as the good God who lovest mankind, remit, forgive, pardon them and us our offenses, voluntary and involuntary, those done with knowledge or ignorance, those manifest or unnoticed, those of deed, of thought, of word, those of all our acts and movements, and those who have been taken from us, give freedom and respite, and bless us who are here present, granting a good and peaceful ending to us and to all thy people, and open unto us thy tender mercies, and thy love of mankind, and thy dread and fearful coming again, and make us worthy of thy kingdom. O great and most high God, who alone art past immortality and dwellest in light unapproachable, who has made all creation in wisdom, who has divided the light from the darkness, and has appointed the sun to rule the day, the moon and the stars to rule the night, who has vouchsafed unto us sinners at this present hour, also to come before thy presence with confession, and to offer unto thee our evening prayers. Do thou thyself, O Lord, who lovest mankind, direct our prayer as a censer before thee, and accept it as a savor of sweet fragrance, and grant that we may pass the present evening and the coming night in peace. Endue us with the armor of life, and deliver us from the terror of the night and from everything that walketh in darkness, and grant that the sleep which thou hast appointed for the repose of our weakness may be free from every imagination of the devil. Yea, O Master, bestower of all good things, may we, being moved to compassion, function upon our beds, call to remembrance thy name in the night, that enlightened by meditation on thy commandments, we may rise up in joyfulness of soul, to glorify thy goodness, offering up prayers and supplications to thy tender love, for our sins and for those of all thy people. Do thou visit in mercy through the intercessions of the holy Theotokos.
Have mercy upon us. Raise us up in peace, O God, by thy grace.
We have the mercy.
All the great remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious, and we have the mercy.
Thank you.
Christ against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
King again. We've been waiting a long time for that, and now it's back. And
course, that also means that our regular times of fasting are back. Next Sunday, right? Is that correct? Yeah? It's a chili cook-off. That's always a lot of fun. In fact, I even say, it's a gas. And if you wonder why we do it on Sunday afternoon instead of Saturday night, well, figure it out. We would not be good company the next day. But I understand some folks are really planning some interesting things this year. I saw one guy on Facebook looking for some bison meat, buffalo, bison, whatever. What do mother buffalo say when her son left? My son. And, you know, people have had various times of threat to make rattlesnake chili. I don't know if anyone's ever done that yet, but, yeah, that would be interesting, wouldn't it? Depending on which part of the snake they use. let's see. Anything else? Is there anything else I need to draw attention to? Do you have an announcement?
I'll announce. Sure.
Mr. President? Parish Council?
We had the privilege yesterday of having the Hoppe family be with us, and they're here with us this morning also. It was an excellent time together, learning about our rich history of missions in the Orthodox Church and how it's being revitalized in the modern day. For the kids ages 9 through high school, Nathan and Gabriella, at the time when it's announced, will come back here in the nave. And they will have a little teaching session for the children also.
Marta, just want to announce about the church work day. It's not next Saturday following.
Church what day?
Work day.
Yeah. In fact, I was going to say that because it says here Sunday. That's Saturday, right? It's the Sunday before Sunday. June 17th. And that's it. Yeah, we need some help for cleaning, painting, and all that kind of fun stuff. I know it's inspirational and you can't wait to sign up, but hey, it's gotta be done. And I forgot to mention, and I would be remiss to say that there is no fasting this week, celebration of the descent of the Holy Spirit. So, what do you have for Holy Spirit?
Also, there's some prayer cards for the Hoppe family that are in the table in the back. Please grab one of those and keep them in your prayers. And we do support them financially, but also as a parish on a monthly basis. If you're inspired to help out a little bit further, they can certainly use that.
Right.